Increase climb.
Now he's pretty close. I'm also flying at the wrong altitude. Should be an even number if he's heading north. Hey guys, welcome to my first of hopefully many FSX videos, and you sit with me right now on the flight deck of the PMDG 737-800 NGX in the Ryanair livery. We're at East Midlands, Echo Golf November X-Ray, and we're going to Alicante, Spain. Lima Echo Alpha Lima. I failed a flight plan, I am on that sim, but no one's about it at the moment, which isn't such a bad thing to be honest. It's been a while since I've flown these. I've been doing a lot of light aircraft. Anyway, let's go ahead and set this up. Ground power. So ground power is now on. There we go. Fans on. Okay, start from the top. IRS set up. Start punching in some stuff on the FMC. Seven minutes until we are aligned. We can still go ahead shooting ATIS, which is brilliant. Where's my trusty little map? Because I can't remember it. Okay, so ATIS 128. Which I'm using V-Pilot as my client because it doesn't seem to impact my frame. However, I can't get the window to stay here, which is really annoying because I can't record in Windows. Oh my god, it's a little line. 5 minutes. MPU is ready to go, but we won't turn on the GOT. Going from East Midlands Airport, we know we're taking runway 9. Destination Lima Echo Alpha Lima. Back in there, flight number today is RYR23 Delta. Next, okay. Before we do this, actually, I'm going to just set up the departure. So we can go down here for departures. And from the chart, we're going to go Delta 34. Right, now we can set this up, so we've got Daventry, and then we're going to Uniform Flight 605 WAD Whiskey Oscar Delta. Uniform Lima 62. Now some people just go straight to the legs page and put the legs in as the flight plan, but I'll show you in a minute why it's better to do it this way. We have got a departure time of 14:40. We make it a different story, but luckily we haven't actually booked it. It's just a time that I've set up hoping to get. Boom! And Valencia! Victor Lima Charlie Osborne. That's good. Now, the reason for that is due to our leg page. But we didn't put half of those in, but they're still there. So if we were to be told to go direct, what didn't like Drake, for instance, if we were told to go direct to Drake, we haven't put that in. You wouldn't have put that into your leg page as per the flight plan. So, if we're flying to Midhurst, as we have on our flight plan, and we are told to go direct to Drake to avoid traffic or for whatever reason, you've then got to punch that in manually rather than just going down here, selecting it, and putting it to the top of the list to go direct. So always do it via the route, not by the legs. Set my fuel weight up actually. Fuel kilos. Oh, what's the conversion of kilos to pounds? Right, get the trusty phone out here. We have a flight time of 2 hours 30 minutes and we need enough fuel for 3 hours 45. We have all of that, but it's all in pounds as opposed to kilos. So now we have enough fuel for the flight. plus an hour and 15 minutes reserve. Reserves, there we go. Right, we're aligned now. This is good. Winds at cruise were... Is that a way to find it itself? I know we've got a headwind. It's 167. Trim needs to be set at 5 punt is loaded. Let's check the legs, make sure there's no discos in there. Okay, we'll be landing at runway 10 via VLC. As I said, I am a little bit rusty doing this, and I've been flying. General aircraft. So why is that's popping up, but I'm not getting... Never mind, it's not too long. So I think we're pretty much ready to go here. Wind is at the destination, so I've got to be honest, I don't really know what I'm doing. Just leave that alone. Right, now I'm happy, we're all ready, we're all set. And for our first restriction to be at 3,000 miles above by the time we get to hold 30. At 9,000 feet there, so we'll whack that to the end. MC3. We're all set up here. Weather test. I'm using Active Sky next.
Monitor radar display. Go around. Wind shear ahead. Wind shear ahead.
I'm not going to make our 20 to 3 takeoffs on that. Looking at the report, I'm not going to hit it. Thank you. pretty much. We'll take off the test TCAS, make sure we're all working. We need to set up the tuning.
TCAS test pass.
We are, so we're looking at a rotate speed of 133. Check doors. Actually, it's doors. Closed doors. Remove chocks. Set. stable starting. Wave, cheery bye, thank you very much. Okay, RTO set. No, paying attention. Set to continuous, both. Taxi lights on. Onto generators. APU off. This up here, a lot easier, I reckon. Gauge checking left side. Left side fire set, should be. Set if you leave it off, fans back on. Okay. Flap set 15. Takeoff trim is set. 4 left, 4 right, 4 back, 4 forward. Left rudder, all right rudder, ah, very good. Okay, check this up complete, we're ready to rock and roll. I'm going fairly well so far, haven't balls up too much, I don't think. Oh, so it's been a while. Anyway, let's taxi, shall we? I didn't do an option test, but anyway. Pretty well out to my local airport. I was supposed to start flying lessons at that a year or two ago. I have been at about 7 or 8 at my boat, but in a time port. PA-38. Very easy to fly too. I'm taxiing out here. We have got real weather on, and the fog has been pretty bad the last few days. But if you're wondering why it took so long for my IRS to align, it's because I do have them set on realistic speed. I'm not going to need much of a takeoff roll here. Airborne, I know it. So we're going to be 6 or 7 minutes off schedule. It's 2.5 hours flight time. So we are due to arrive in Spain. At 5 don't know if anyone's clear, no one has announced that they're on final. Landing lights on, taxi off, strobe lights on, and we're ready to rock and roll. So we'll find out on this. Positive red gear up. Match 5. Okay, speed brake off. Flaps up. Very, very fast take. Okay, so we can see we're going to be battling a headwind. Climbing out now, I suppose some people will be unhappy if that didn't announce my intention. And welcome back to the flight deck. Now, I'll just bring you back just for a second, just to show you how good Active Sky Next is. Look at that. The haze and the cloud layering. We're at cruise now at 35,000 feet. And I think that is, this is the first time I've been up this high with Active Sky, and I'm really impressed with it. It's definitely worth buying, and it makes your weather radar work, which is always a bonus. Obviously it's not picking up anything now, because there isn't anything to pick up, but just thought I'd show you that. And also the headwind that I had, I wasn't lying, look at that, with a 44 knot headwind. So our flight time of 2.5 hours could be a little bit more. We're up at cruise now, and I'll bring you back just for top of descent. Welcome back once again to the flight deck, and we are approaching top of descent. So what we're going to do here is go through and find out our first restriction, which at Vilna we need to be at 8,000 feet according to the chart. So I want to dial in that. Okay, I've had to make a few adjustments to the approach, but we should be good to go. So we're half an hour from our estimated arrival time of 5:15. The headwind died down. The headwind died down. As the flight went on, which has been good news. We've made up a little bit of time through that, not an awful lot. Okay, we'll start our descent. The engines are coming back. Whilst we're here, we will dial in the ILS frequency for Alicante, Lima, Echo, Alpha, Lima, which is 110 0.3. Dial that in there. Okay. Flaps, we're going to go flaps 30. Put that in there. Wind correction plus 5 knots. So we want a landing speed of 145, which I will set later on. But we've got the course set up. The heading is going to be 1012. Should I say as well, otherwise that could sound quite confusing. And I think I sorted my microphone problems out, because you can't really hear me in the first part of the video. I did have a quick listen back. Hopefully I've sorted that problem out. Right, auto brake of 2. We're going to be light, so we're not going to need a massive amount of braking. We will stop pretty rapidly. Except on here is this there, very similar to as though you're approaching a glide slope. So at the moment we're a little below the descent path that we need to be, but it doesn't matter, it's not a problem. Okay, so we're under 30,000 feet now. Let's see if I can tune ATIS. I don't suppose I can get them just yet, but let's have a go anyway. So we want 120. 075, because this could knacker everything up here. No, we're too far away at the moment, but try again when we get a little bit closer. I have no idea what the range is. No idea what's all. Right, so the nav, the DME in there saying 110.3, and we have got 110.3. That's fine. Let's just put the weather down to see if there's anything coming up. Hopefully not. The weather report on the way down was pretty good, so we'll see what happens, won't we? So, just to go over a few things, we've got course and navigation set up at 110.3 and a course of 101. We have heading at 101 should we need to go around. Auto brake set at 2. We have it all done. Oops, 70. There we go. And we're landing flaps 30 at 140 plus wind correction of 5 knots. So we'll be landing speed of 145. Everything on here is good. Wait for the temperature to drop and we can turn the ant off. Minus 16 at the moment. So I'm happy everything is set up here. What's that destination? We do not have one. Glide slope on. Landing gross weight would be 58.4. Okay. Do I have any necessary lights on in the cabin? Nope. Landing altitude, I did not check. Bad, isn't it? Because I mean, I can't set this, but we'll be fine. Currently on a course of 198. Okay. Should we need to go around, we fly out and fly straight at 4,000 feet. Making a right turn. Hopefully that won't be the case. And I really need to get FTX Global, because I've only got FTX England at the minute. And default scenery is just not very good, is it? Let's be honest. Okay, so we're approaching Valletta, which is our star. 6.5 miles away. We're not that far away from our final tip. It's about 55 nautical miles. Now, the terrain map on, the weather can come off because we are navigating mountains, which you can start to see building up in the distance. Flight director is on. Tray tables in their upright positions and seat belts fastened. Okay, I'm happy. I've got everything covered here. Okay, we're looking good on the descent. Speed's looking fine. Let's just check our legs, make sure we're all... Seems to be at 220 by Vilna, which is another 60 miles. And at 8,000 feet. But that's a maximum altitude of 8,000 feet, so we can come down. And then we need to be at 3,000 or above by the time we get on our approach leg. Just check this, no more warnings. Yep, we're all good there. Can we tune ATIS in yet? I don't know what the range is. Drag required. Speed brake. Oh, I love that noise. Okay, now we're still out of range. And this has been a pretty smooth flight, apart from the bit of turbulence as the wind shifted. But apart from that, we've been pretty good. ILS 1, course 101. It's good. Mountains below those clouds already. Okay, so far flight time 2 hours and 4 minutes, so we still have 25, actually no, you've got to add 3 or 4 minutes onto that, so 20 minutes we've still got to be there in time. And if we get there in time, use your imagination and play the little Ryanair jingle in your ears, it'd be brilliant. Okay. We're below the speed we need now, so we can turn drag off and bring back the speed brake. Okay, I've got two different frequencies for the Otis. Let me try this one. Oh no, I was on it. No, it's fine. One, two, one, seven. I'm getting hit. Let's try it. Oh, don't tell me that's me. Someone's on the line. This could be a problem. The video may cut out while I try and sort the... Okay, and we're back. And we're getting turbulence. Brilliant. No, it is 12007, so... Why are we not picking it? Let's see if we can have a look on here. In all fairness, we still are 40 plus miles away, so... This could be quite a bumpy landing by the looks of things. The hardest part I've got to remember now is how to activate the approach phase and everything. It's been so long. Let's just bring the speed brake up here just to try and bleed a bit more speed off. I'm going to need to be down to 250 anytime soon, so... Plus 10 degrees already, and we're at 11,500 feet. It's not even been that warm in the UK at ground level. Okay, put them on. We're a bit early, but it doesn't matter. It's one less job. Let's even get Otis yet. Unicom, so we know what's going on. Okay, we need to bleed that speed off because we're coming under 10,000 feet now. We need to be at 250 knots or below. So speed brake is armed. Oh, brilliant. That's what we wanted. Just as well we land an ILS, eh? Okay, it might just be in a cloud layer, that's fine. Okay, we're coming up on Vilna, and we need to be at 3,300 by the time we get to that one, CI-10Y, which is the approach path for ILS runway 10. So we'll dial in 3,300 on here, and once we are established we will then dial in 4,000 feet in case of go around. Just check this weather, just make sure we haven't got anything coming up. Our flight level. weather on his side. Now terrain on my side. Okay. And there is a very sophisticated approach, a very professional approach, or an a way to do this approach, and I may have to learn it and give it a go. If any of you got Navigraph, you can go on and have a look at a video tutorial and have a look at how this approach is flown. Okay, should be able to tune 80 by now, I'd think. Still no, brilliant. And get Talbot on 80, why? If anyone's watching this video, please tell me what the range is on 80. It'd be very... Definitely got the correct frequency, that's not a problem. No, I haven't. Why is that? Oh, it's because we changed it to tower. 12007. Okay, drag. Pay more attention. Final checks. Flaps up, course is set. Altitude 330. Right, on the correct descent path. Gearbox currently armed. DME 21.6 miles away. Course 101. Just coming on Villeneuve, we need to be at 220, which we've just achieved now. Okay, left turn any second. There we go. Approach is alive. Let's bring the speed down here. Okay, 115, that might, I don't know what ATIS is. I'm going to have to press P here because I don't know. It's very annoying. And then there is Alicante Airport. Oops, what was just done? Okay, we need to bleed this speed off. Okay, coming up on 3,300. Still need to lose speed. Okay, we're above approach path, but that's fine.
2,500.
Okay. Approach has been found. Flaps one. Flaps five, VOR lock. Speed brake is set. Go around altitude set. Oops, no, not yet. Okay, glide slope alive. Why am I not picking this up? Speed brake in, speed brake armed for landing. Reduce speed. 160, flaps 15. Okay, coming up on 8 miles out, gear down. Turn off lights on. I have no idea if you can hear me now because some crazy noise. Gears down, 3 green, auto brake set, flaps 15. Glide slope is alive. Runway in sight. Go around altitude set. Okay, flaps 25. Speed 154. Speed 145. Flaps 30. Autopilot disengaged. I have control. Landing. Okay, that's pretty successful, I would say. Speed braking, flaps up. Landing lights off, taxi on, APU start. Onto steady. Okay. That's everything cleared up. And the time is 12 minutes past 5. We were early, and we're 6 minutes late taking off, so we can't moan too much. Gate 33 looks good to me. Okay, parked up. Taxi lights off. Oop. APU on. Anti-collision can go off. Turn off lights can go off. APU bleed. And engine shutdown. Off. And we'll go off. The pump's off. And definitely off. Your damper is off. And that's one flight done. And feel free to go onto YouTube, search for a Ryanair on-time jingle. Because we got here on time. Anyway guys, thanks for watching. There'll be another one up soon. I apologise for the audio at the start. If there's anything that wasn't quite right, let me know. As I say, I haven't done any flying in this thing for a little while. But it all came back to me, I think. There's a few things I might have missed. But anyway, thanks for watching. If you liked it, hit that like button. Cheers guys.